Keeping It Real. I'm your host, Reverend Al Sharpton, and yesterday we saw the policeman that shot 12-year-old Tamir Rice in Cleveland fired, another one suspended. But fired, as I said earlier on this show, and as I said on my commentary, weekly commentary on the Tom Joyner Show this morning, fired not for killing Tamir Rice. Jumped out the car and second shot a young man, 12 years old, with a toy gun. Never checked the gun, never saw what was going on, whether he was even endangered. He wasn't fired for that. He was fired for falsifying his job application. So today, the Greater Cleveland Chapter National Action Network, led by our chairman, the eminent pastor of the historic Greater Abyssinian Baptist Church of Cleveland, Reverend E.T. Cavanaugh, and Marcia McCoy, our president, and others, will be holding a press conference. I have Dr. Cavanaugh on our hotline. Reverend Cavanaugh, tell us what's going on there in Cleveland.
My brother, thank you very kindly. The mayor, along with the police chief, ascertained charges against these gentlemen that allowed them to fire one and suspend one for 10 days. As you well know, Reverend Sharpton, in these kinds of cases, it's very technical. In fact, we began this whole process with the state attorney general almost giving freedom to these persons because he said of systemic problems. So with all of the transpiration that went along with this, we were caught with having to fight almost with our hands behind us. But because the mayor was persistent and because we have a dynamic and energetic police chief, Calvin Williams, who does everything to stay focused and doing the job, we were able to get through and get one of these guys fired and the other to take 10 days off and is beginning today. And so really the dismissal had to be due to the broken rules and not the boy's death, unfortunately. All of us know that it deserved punishment, but trying to circumvent the legalities that strangle us from being able to fire police people, the blue code and all of what's involved in this, we did the best we could with what we had. And the mayor needs to be commended, and the police chief certainly, for doing a great job of making sure Tamir Rice's mother was relieved and got some concern.
And this is a reality that we talk about every day, why we've got to deal with these state and local laws, because the laws are so inhibitive. Even when you have a situation as glaring as this, you've got to deal with those local laws or you can't get anything done. And in this case, you had to use another way to get something done, but at least you got one fired.
Absolutely, Dr. Sharpton, and you're eminently correct. We were, the state attorney general, in when this began, almost gave absolute freedom to these guys by saying it was systemic and not due to their behavior. Obviously, we know that they came so close to this young man. That's one of the reasons why we were able to get Frank Wormack 10 days, or because he drove too close to Lil Tamir. And we also took care of the dispatcher who did not give the information to the police. So you had a very technical situation that developed in a young 12-year-old's death. But police people following the rules went along with it. And so with all the complications that we had, the only way that this persistent mayor and energetic police chief was able to get some resolution to this as much as we could was through the technicalities that we found that this guy broke the rules. He did not relay to us his past, and this other guy drove close to Tamir. And so that allowed us, the police chief and the safety director, to come together and say, we're going to fire this guy, and then will he be able to fire and kill another child.
All right, and where will the press conference be today?
We're trying to get that together right now. We hope it's going to be downtown, but we're very grateful, Dr. Sharpton, for your persistence in making sure you stay on the case, and your power and your influence has done a good job with enabling us to get this resolution.
All right, thank you for your calls.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for the information.
All right, my brother.
Let me say that it is important to me that people understand that these fights have got to be done. I want to say this in a very emphatic and proper way. They have to be done on the ground, and they have to be done in a way that deals with the municipal, the county, city and state, as well as federal laws. We must be well prepared to deal with the reasons and the rationales that they hold us down and why they hold us down. We must be prepared for that. And I think that a lot of us are not prepared to deal with that. I think that it is very, very clear that in these times that we have a real opportunity to use the momentum of the fervor that Donald Trump has generated with his just callous and blatant behavior to now organize. The bad news is we're facing it. The good news is that a lot of people that never thought this was possible are saying, this is real. What can I do? And you ought to use that as an opportunity to therefore go and do something about it. And I think that it is important. I think that it is imperative. I think that it is something that we all, as a community,